Hello people! Today I will share my top 10 tips for emergency flood evacuation.
It's empty, Merritt. It's totally empty.
So, tip number one, have an emergency plan. This is, for example, something that I will share today with you, so that you will know all the steps to take before you leave your house, depending on how much time you have to leave your house. Tip number two, have an emergency spot in your house. So, this is one spot in your place where you live that you collect all the most important essentials that are easy to grab. For example, passports, IDs, all the cash you have in the house, some other important documents and papers you really need. This is your main to-go spot where you go and grab the things and get out of your house if you have to leave very fast. Tip number three, have an emergency bag with other random things that can be very useful if you just have to leave your house immediately. For example, a bag with, you know, toothbrush, toothpaste, some painkillers, maybe some diapers, you know, all these kinds of things, like a travel cosmetic bag. Tip number four, bring some water and some food, because it will be uncertain when you will be the next time have a possibility to go to the store and buy things like water and food. You know, so make sure you're covered for the day, so that no matter what, you will not have a hungry feeling above all things. Tip number five, if you have enough time before leaving your house, you can go around your house and lift some important things from the floor. For example, put them on the couch, on your table, on the chairs, you know, like important things or things that are of value or maybe expensive things. If you have the time, you can just lift them a little higher and it will reduce the risk of them being wet. Tip number six, keep enough fuel in your vehicle. So when you have to leave, at least you will have enough fuel to get out of town. Because if there is a possibility that, you know, the queues on the gas station will be too long or the gas stations will be closed, that at least you will have the ability to get to the next town where hopefully the gas stations will be open. Now, tips a little bit more to do with the mental health. Tip number seven, count your blessings. You know, realize that things could still be a lot worse. For example, my whole family got safely evacuated. So this is for me the most important, that my whole family is alive and well. So we don't have to worry about this. My house did not crumble yet. So there is a chance of restoring my house. So there is all these things we can be thankful for and for all the good things that we still have in our life. Tip number eight, don't put too much value on your worldly possessions. Because in the end, you know, we will all leave without our possessions. Our possessions do not create who we are. We are who we are. And we should not hold too much value on possessions. As I learned now the hard way, things can be taken away very fast. Tip number nine, keep a positive attitude. Because a negative attitude does not solve any problems. So in all things, try to be optimistic, positive, try to find a solution to the problems. So don't fixate on the problems, but spend your time, you know, thinking about the good things, thinking about how we can resolve the problems, the situations, maybe we can improve things, you know, see it as a way of opportunity as well. And last tip of the day, and I will leave this tip up to you because I know for sure more people are going to the same thing. Maybe they have some important tips that they have learned from personal experience now that they can share. So please share your tip in the comments below. Anything that I haven't mentioned yet so we can all help each other. Anyways, thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe for more videos and see you next time.